I'm here in the forest near the Zobes uranium mining area, a few hundred meters away from the remains of one of the spoil heaps. There is also a former prospecting site nearby. As you can hear, it didn't take too long to find the first hotspot. My goal is once again to find botryoidal pitchblende, which is quite rare here. This is spoil material from one of the prospecting trenches, which were not very deep, however. Here in the forest, I mainly expect to find pieces that were lost during the transport of the ore. The forest already existed during the mining period in the 1950s and early 1960s. So far, the specimens haven't been impressive. Let's see if that will change. Now the interesting part begins. As you can see, there is a massive pile of trash underneath the small tree here, and some potent hotspots. You can already tell that this can't be low-grade ore. Time to investigate further. This piece isn't quite the treasure I had hoped for, but let's continue the excavations. Nothing interesting again, but the device is still ticking, so let's continue. You don't have to be fluent in German to understand this statement. My amazement mainly relates to the weight of this small chunk. It's incredibly heavy, like solid lead. Look at all this trash. Does anyone know what was disposed of here? Please tell me if you do. The question also arises as to whether the pieces were lost here in the course of mining, or whether someone deliberately disposed of them here.
Okay.
I think we are still not done here.
Ach du Scheiße.
Now I can count the search for botryoidal uraninite as a success. Take a look at those massive spheres. A very thick layer of pure uraninite. Unfortunately, you can't see much through the dirt yet. Time for some on-site cleaning. This golden coating makes me feel a little uneasy. I don't know what to make of it. On one hand, there is a lot of pyrite here on these minerals. But on the other hand, it could also be the work of a madman. By that I mean, it could also be paint or lacquer. But why would anyone spray paint pitch blend in a golden color? Or how likely is it that this is really a coating of pyrite on this fantastic botryoidal specimen? Well, I did some testing with multiple variants of lacquer thinner and airbrush cleaner. There was no reaction whatsoever from the chemicals, so I assume it's pyrite. For me, it's a sensational find.